Hey there, Jason McMillian here from jAlbum.net. I'm making this recording for two reasons actually. The first one is to encourage you to sign up and start making some money with jAlbum if you're using it anyway. Great opportunity. And the second one is to go through the actual sign up process because, to be honest, it gave me a headache the first time I looked at the Commission Junction sign up form. But after I went through it, through the sign-up form, filled in my contact details, and then it's just mostly about clicking your way through the rest of the form, and it's not that bad actually. But we've noticed a lot of our users and customers get stuck in the registration process, so I felt it was necessary for me to do this video. So please sign up, it's a great opportunity. Who knows, you might make some money. And now I'll show you how to work your way through the registration process. Good luck. So this is my blog post about getting paid by simply using jAlbum. And to get started, you need to sign up with our partner, Commission Junction, as a publisher. Let's do that. I'll click on the link there. Now we're on the Commission Junction website, free publisher sign up, and sign up today. This is the first page and the sign up process that has a total of two pages. And this first page is really straightforward. We select our language. I'll go for English and country and the currency you'd like to get paid in. Let's click on next. Now a small pop-up appears here and it's just Commission Junction informing you that they want to keep high quality and the content you publish. So let's close that. I can scroll down. This is the second page in the sign up process, and I'll scroll down just so you can see how long the second page is. It's not that bad. Okay, so we start out by accepting their terms and conditions. And the way to do that is to scroll down, well, you actually need to read this too. To scroll down all the way to the bottom and click on the accept button. And the sort of confusing thing now is that nothing seems to happen when you click on the accept button, but it does enable you to accept their terms and conditions. In other words, it allows you to click this checkbox. So scroll down, click on accept, and then you can click on the accept their terms and conditions. Let's continue. There are a few more checkboxes that need to be checked here. Code of conduct, in other words, behave. Privacy policy, okay. You have to be over 18. Check. Certification of authority, this means that you have the right to publish whatever you're publishing on your website or jAlbum album. This section here, I think, is unnecessary since it only applies to you if you live in China. You'll have to check it anyway, even though it doesn't really apply to you. So now we're finished with the terms and conditions. Now we have to fill in our user details. So we start by filling in our website, blog, or the name of our jAlbum album. And here we type in the address. So if you have a jAlbum account, you would type in your name.jAlbum.net. And here you type in a description. Then you move on and select a category for your website, blog, or jAlbum album. How many visitors you think you have. If you just have a website or blog or jAlbum album, you'll click here, website/content. And again, if you have a jAlbum album, you're not offering any incentives to your visitors to do anything special. So you can click no there, and you don't need to type in any description here either. Good. So this is the last section of the sign-up form, your contact information, the standard procedure, your name, phone number, email address, and so on. If you have a company, you fill in your company details here. If you don't, you simply fill in your name and your home address
etc., etc. And now you're done. You filled in the Commission Junction sign-up form. You click on Accept Terms. What happens next is that you'll get an email and with your login information. Use that to log into the Commission Junction publisher panel. And from there, you'll get your unique tracking code. And I'll open jAlbum now and just quickly show you how to or where to paste it. I'll go to Sample Portfolio, click on the Settings button. You go all the way to Advanced. You go to User Variables. And usually, these will be empty. Now in the Sample Portfolio, we have a gray filter here. But the only thing you do now is double click, you type in the name from the blog post, and this is the value. This is where you copy in your unique tracking link. You click OK, and you're done. Just a reminder, you do need to click on Make Album here and upload the album again for the tracking link to be in your web album. That's it. It's that simple. Well, the sign-up process did take some time, but after you've finished, now all of your albums will have this tracking link, and you can make money from, well, generally everything you do with jAlbum. So, good luck.